not going to kill it, but still slow it down. Really, that's not. I don't think that's doing enough. Economically, Demon is really down now at this point, and he's not. Doesn't look like he has anything to recover with. And here's a naval yard coming down for RA3 Latvia, and it just looks like he's completely owning. You know, he's going to own the water and just come in here and push that out and kill these power plants, and then be able to threaten Demon from any angle, and that's sort of the beauty of taking the water, and that's why Red Alert 3 is actually such an awesome game, because you know maps are fought with basically on islands, and there's a whole other element to it. If one player gets naval superiority and can hold off the other player on the land, he can eventually get to tier 3 naval bombardment units, and that's shuts things down. I mean, we all know that obviously, but that's why we all play this game. At least that's why I think it's the greatest game ever. And now we're going to have a fight. Demon provoked RA3 Latvia by going after the oil derrick, and he's going to lose one of those Guardian tanks, sort of a wasted cryo shot there. He's going to lose another Guardian tank. RA3 Latvia has done an excellent job of snaring these Guardians, and now that's the third one that's gone down, and he managed to easily snipe off three Guardians. This is a massive army he's got, and now he's even got a naval yard. He can produce bullfrogs right here and just spam hammer tanks out of his war factory. It's actually a pretty useful thing if he does that, and he doesn't need to be building all those flak troopers. But he's got a lot of flak guys. He's got a lot of different barracks around the map. Actually, just the one, I guess. He sold the earlier ones. This is a gigantic army from RA3 Latvia, and now he's got an Akula sub, which is definitely going to take out the ore refinery here, the turret, and probably just snipe power plants all day long. And it can do it by itself. That's the beauty of it. He could sell this naval yard right now, and that Akula sub would win the war. This one Riptide is going to finish off that harvester. Although now that I think about it, he can build Riptides out of the armor facility to go kill the thing. I don't think it's going to be enough to do it, but and that'll prevent him from building enough units to stop this push. And I think RA3 Latvia should have made that push already, just now, made that push, and that would have been the way to go. But now he's producing cryocopters, and that's going to make a difference here, because shrinking these tanks, shrinking the MCV, that's going to make this a lot more potent a force than it appears to be right now. And immediately that MCV goes down. Didn't get in there, didn't even disrupt his position, soaked barely any damage because the other forces just weren't in range in time to make any serious significant difference there. And all these dogs coming in from the side are gonna bark these bears out. Oh, this one bear saved Latvia's army there. But these massive amount of hammer tanks is trying to push into this defensive line that Demon has, and it doesn't look like it's really going to do much damage here. This one flak trooper seems to be... Oh, he could have killed that harvester if he'd done that, and it would have been a lot to stem the tide, but that's a lot of hammer tanks down for RA3 Latvia. It appears he went in thinking he had it and was overconfident, and just the sheer amount of firepower with all these rocket guys and all these Guardian tanks set up specifically in a defensive position to stop that from doing any damage. And these bears could have done a lot more to kill these javelin guys, but it did a decent job stunning a bunch of them, and now he's just suiciding his hammer tanks in to try to run over as many javelin guys as he can. It's the only thing he can really do at this stage, and that terror drone probably should have gone and tried to infect at least one of these hammer tanks. But now... the unit advantage is clearly on the side of Demon, and yeah, that refinery went down to the Akula sub. But honestly, I don't think that was really enough. These bears are going to get in here and definitely kill all these javelin guys. Wow, actually, maybe not with the. It's probably an upgraded. That's the upgraded version of. So he's on high technology right now, and well, he's gonna with the Guardian tank and the cryo on the refineries. That's pretty quick to take him down. And that's a lot of Guardian tanks, and there's no anti-air to keep these cryocopters from just freezing the Guardian tanks over there. RA3 Lavia's forces are split in half. He doesn't really have a cohesive strike force he can put together here, and Demon looks like he just might steamroll this whole thing. There's no MCV, there's no crane. There is the naval yard to rebuild an MCV, and he just might be doing exactly that. But this force of hammer tank or Guardian tanks, I mean, backed up by these rocket guys and peacekeepers now, is really that's going to be difficult to stop. And here's an expansion point for Demon, who's obviously now got the upper hand and feels like he can expand. I'm not really sure what the Stingray was about. I don't think that the Stingray is going to stop this many Guardian tanks, but killing that Harvester was a definite step in the right direction for Demon. Oh, he's Q moving, that's why. And I think that's probably what happened in this battle between Latvia and Demon, where Demon completely wiped out Latvia's far superior, an army that looked far superior, although he lost previous battles and attrition really, you know, did get to him. Now this Riptide's heroic, he took that out, but it's no contest with an Akula, you know, one-on-one. Now we've got a decent amount of hammer tanks here with Bullfrog support, and it looks like RA3 Lavia doesn't exactly know what he wants to do with them. It appears he's going to lose his main base if he doesn't do something dramatic right now, but obviously he's not going to come and defend that, and he's just going to move these hammer tanks into his opponent's base and I guess try to destroy him if he can. But with the Vindicators and multi-gunner support, I just don't see it happening. Even if he kills the Harvester, he's just not in that kind of a position, and I'm not really sure why Demon is even coming home. He can beat this easily. Not easily, I guess. There are a lot of tanks there. But he does have a lot of turrets, and he can slow that down a long time, and he can get that construction yard out of there, and he's not going to lose all this to that. I guess he didn't want to have a base race, and he just wanted to be sure about it, because at this point, yeah, he doesn't... okay, it is smart. At this point, RA3 Lafayette doesn't have a way to reproduce any force, and so the most important thing is the forces he's got on the map, and not necessarily actually ending the game itself. And this is over, obviously. There's not much to be done for either player. It's a decent game, though. I think the main thing that allowed Demon to just walk away with this was the fact that RA3 Latvia actually just... he overestimated the potential of his force in terms of being able to crack Demon's wall there, and this was that wall. I'm relatively certain when Demon had his whole army there, you know, I don't know, 12 Guardian tanks and 15, 20 rocket guys, and that mixed force from RA3 Latvia just could not stand up to the sustained, you know, massive amount of damage. And we can see here they were relatively even until the end on, you know, harassing structures. And this is about the point where RA3 Latvia obviously built that fifth refinery and pulled ahead. The unit kill death ratio tells that story that I was telling earlier. And the efficiency ratio is pretty close to it. And because I feel like a wonderful human being, I'm going to do two games.